Hi everyone, this is Ravi. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. As you all know, I have recently published the lesson 8 on Tricentis Tosca test design specialist concepts. So in which I have covered the topic related to classes. How do we create classes? And then how can you use the class in your existing multiple test sheets so that you can reduce the redundancy of your work. So let me cover some more topics related to test sheets in the upcoming session. Please do subscribe to the channel, click on bell icon, you'll receive notifications whenever I publish more videos. Stay tuned. This is our lesson 9 on Tricentis Tosca test design concepts. So in this lesson, I'm going to cover the topics or I'm going to teach you how to integrate the newly introduced attributes into your existing test sheet. And also, how can you integrate and adapt the new features that has been introduced in your application that you are testing, so that you can adapt these new features to your test sheet. And also, I'm going to teach you how can you combine the combinations in your test sheets at lower level and also at the test sheet level, so that you can complete entire test sheet values along with your newly introduced features. This is more like practical session rather than a theoretical session. I'm going to walk you through the Tosca tool so that you can understand these concepts. Okay, so what are our agenda items for this session? So in this session, you will learn how to integrate a new feature of your system under test or of your application into your existing test sheet. That means, let's say you have already started automating your application by using Tosca. So when you are in middle of automating all your test cases, let's assume your application undergone through the changes and a new feature has been added in your application. So then how can you integrate that new feature to your existing test sheet? And also, the addition of new features into an application is a very common feature, right? So basically, whenever you start automating your application, it's very common that your application undergoes with a lot of changes. So it's very common. So now you need to integrate this new feature and the corresponding instances with data into your existing test sheet, because you already prepared one test sheet, but now your application has been changed. So that means you have to adopt these changes in terms of instances into your existing test sheet. So I'm going to teach you how to do that. And also, to add the new attribute, you simply create an attribute wherever it is logically applicable to the test sheet. That means, so how do you adapt the new features? Basically, you will be creating attributes, new attributes that are applicable for your new feature into your test sheet. Okay, so let me show you practically so that you will understand very well. Okay, and also you must remember to complete the test sheet and to complete the combinations on all levels, from lowest level up to the test sheet level. What does it mean? Let's say, because of the new feature in your application, you need to create new attributes with the additional instances, for example. So whenever you create a new attribute at a logical place, first you need to create a combinations at lower level. So once you create the test combinations at lower level in test sheet, you should create combinations at higher level, at test sheet level as well. Okay, you will be creating test combinations at attribute level, and then you will be creating combinations at test sheet level. So that is very important. Okay, so when I start walk you through the application, you will clearly understand what I'm talking. And also ensure that there are no missing values at each level. That means you should not miss any value at attribute level and also at test sheet level. As you all know, in my previous test automation specialist concepts, Tricentis TASCA test automation specialist concepts, we have used an application provided by Tricentis, which is a web shop, right? So that web shop application, if you see on the screen, this is our web shop application, which is a system under test. Let's assume, okay? In checkout process, there are five different modules. One is billing address is one module, shipping address is another module, and then payment method is another module, and payment information is another module, confirm order is another module. So these are all different features within checkout, right? So if you see, let's assume we started automating our application by using Tricentis with these modules. So in middle, let's say there is a new feature that has been introduced in checkout process, the feature called shipping method. Let's assume. So now you already prepared your test cases in test design module, and you already prepared your test sheet with all the modules that are available except shipping method. So now, because a new feature called shipping method has been introduced, now you need to adapt these feature in your existing test sheet. How can you adapt? How can you create new attributes? And then how can you adapt those attributes into your test sheet? So I'm going to explain this particular scenario in TASCA, then you will be understanding very clearly. So as I told you, in our example, in our scenario, whatever we are doing, we have a new set of radio buttons within checkout with different shipping method options, right? Ground, second day, next day. So these are all the different radio button options that we have. So we will actually need to test each of these methods, right? So that means I have to test a standard method or straight through method called ground shipping, and also have another methods called next day shipping, second day shipping, and not applicable. So these are all the combinations that I have to test. To test these combinations, I have to create attributes. I have to create test data combinations in my test sheet, in my existing test sheet. So how can I adapt all these combinations, all these testing instances into my existing test sheet? Okay, so without delaying, let's jump onto our system and see how can we adapt this new feature called shipping method in our test sheet. Okay, this is my Tricentis TASCA automation tool where we are working on test case design module, right? So in my previous session, I have explained you about the classes and all the adapting the classes, right? So now let's assume we created classes and we are in middle of preparing our test sheet. Okay, this is my test sheet. Okay, this entire test sheet, whatever we prepared in our previous session. Okay, so now let's assume when you are in process of preparing this entire test sheet, let's say your test system under test application has been changed. What is our system under test application? That is our demo web shop. Let's say, as I explained you, when you are preparing your test cases and your test case combinations by using
test sheets under test case design because your application undergone with a change. What is the change? The change is in checkout process, a new method has been introduced or a new feature has been introduced, the feature called shipping method. This has multiple choices. You can choose a shipping method of ground, you can choose a shipping method of next day air, you can choose a shipping method of second day air, or you can choose not applicable, shipping method is not applicable. So now, because the new feature has been introduced, you need to design your test cases to cover these tests, right? And also you have to automate all your test cases related to this new feature. Because we are in middle of our test case design and test sheet design, how can we adapt this new feature? That I'm gonna explain you now, okay? So for that, let me go back to my Tricentis Tasker tool. What I'll do, I'll copy this test design folder from my previous session, copy, and let me paste it. I don't want to disturb the previous session folders, okay? I'm just pasting it, and then let me rename this as session 09 integrate new attribute, new feature attributes. Okay, let's say this is our new folder. Okay, so now the application has been enhanced where? Under process called checkout, right? So for that, you just need to focus on your checkout module. Okay, your checkout attribute. So here, if you see, we have billing address, shipping address, payment method. So now, a new feature has been added called shipping method. So for that, first I need to create a new attribute by right clicking on the checkout and name this as shipping method, right? So under shipping method, I have three different options, as I told you, right? Ground, next day, second day. So for that, I have to create new instances here. My first instance is ground, and my second instance is next day air, and my third instance is second day air, right? And also another instance called not applicable. Okay, so I have added an attribute called shipping method to my existing test sheet, and I have added four different instances right here. So now, as I explained you in theoretical session, whenever you add any new attributes while deriving your test data combinations, first you have to cover your lower level test data combinations, and then you should go to your upper level. Okay, so now under shipping method, we defined our attributes. So ground is my straight through. So let me make this as a straight through. Okay, this is my straight through. Now if you focus on test checkout attribute, you need to add two additional instances. So if you see, I have instance called standard shipping, in-store pickup, and no shipping. But now we have a ground shipping, we have next day air shipping, second day air shipping, correct? So for that, I need to add instance at checkout attribute level. My first instance is next day air, and The another instance is second day air. Okay, now I have added these new attributes at checkout level. So then what should we do? Here, now you have to fill your values or you have to derive your test data combinations. For that, let me first shipping method. My standard shipping method is ground. So that's why I'm selecting straight through value here. And in store pickup. So because you are picking up in store, the shipping method is not applicable. So I'm selecting not applicable. And no shipping. Here also it is not applicable. Right? Now we have a two additional attributes at checkout level. So now we have to fill these two additional attributes, right? Now for that, let me use one method to fill all these. For billing, shipping and payment method, I would like to fill the values by right clicking and then fill empty values with specific values. And here first is default, that is done, means billing method. And then next one is billing address, so that is done. And next one is credit card and visa, right? So that means billing address has been filled with one of the specific value called default, shipping address has been filled with equals billing, and payment method with credit card. So I have filled all these values, right? So now here shipping method for the new attribute, this is next day shipping, right? So for that I have to select my next day air, that new instance whatever I added at shipping method level. And here my new instance is second day air. So that means now I have created new attributes at shipping method level and then derived my test data combinations by using linear expansion method. Please do visit my previous videos, okay, where I have explained you about linear expansion methods. Okay, what we did, we derived our combinations at shipping method level and then we went up to checkout attribute level and then we filled all the values. We need to make sure that you do not have any empty values at each level, as I explained you. So now this is done. So once we finish this, now you need to fill your, you need to, let me just fit this, okay? Let me right click best fit, okay? So now we have completed at lower level. Now we have to do this test data combination exercise at test sheet level. So that means you double click on this calculate shipping. Now here you have to complete the newly added attributes, right, at test sheet level also. So for that, what we need to do, you'll be going to the test sheet level, and here if you see, I do not have a shipping method called second day air or my next day air, correct? So for that you have to add a new instances at test sheet level. So let me add a new instance called next day air and another new instance called second day air. Okay, so as soon as I add the new instances at test sheet level, now I need to derive my test data combinations. So what is your best method? So the best method is by using filter. Okay, by using filter, I want to first fill the newly added instances. I want to fill all the levels, okay? For that, go to filter, uncheck all, just select your next day and second day, right? So this will filter out all other attributes and it keeps only the newly added attributes. Now, once you filter, I would like to fill the values now, okay? Let me just expand this, okay? expand my, okay. So now let me select this, 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 and then customer. Now I want to fill all these values. How? Go to fill empty values, select specific. Now I want to populate test designer with this value. I want to populate Peter business with this value. And then I want to populate test stage with regression. And I want to populate customer with register address. So that means now I'm able to populate all the values of these attributes for the newly added instances, right? So once that is done, so now let me add values at order products. So for next day air, I want to cover the physical. And also for this, I want to go for the straight through, which is physical. And checkout, we already know for next day air, we already here, if you see, we already filled this, right? At test sheet level, I want to select next day air. And then I want to select here, second day air. This is our newly added instance, right? So by this, probably we have completed filling everything. Okay, let me just filter out my select all. So let me just do this. So if you see now, let me fit best fit all columns. Okay, if you see here, I have filled all my test sheets, right? Entire my test sheet after adapting the newly added feature, right? So if you see, I filled everything. I can just expand all this order products is done. This is done. This is done. So if you see here, we have selected all our test combinations at test sheet level. So what you understand? So if you have any change in your application, adopting your feature should be first at the lower level. First, you will be creating the new attributes at a logical level, at any level where it is applicable. So once you add the new attribute, you have to derive your test data combinations at lower level, like checkout first. Once you finish your test data combinations at lower level, and then you have to go to test sheet level, and then you need to create a new instances corresponding to the new feature, and then you need to derive test data combinations by filling all the values. Okay, so this is how you can adopt your new features, or if you can adopt your any changes in your application in the existing test sheet. Hope it is very, very important concept. Hope you all understand the concepts. If you have any questions, just provide your queries in the comment box, okay, so that I can reply to you guys.
Hope you all understand the concepts of integration of new attributes into your existing test sheet, and then integration of your new features of your system under test into your existing test sheets, and also how can you complete the combinations at all levels, from lower level up to your test sheet level. If you have any questions, leave comments in your comment box so that I can reply to your queries. Please do subscribe to the channel. Click on bell icon. You'll receive notifications whenever I publish more videos on task or concepts. Please don't forget to share and like the video. Thank you.